Everybody, welcome back. It is Jeff again. Another episode from the Mindcrack server. Just telling Arcus that his building's looking good while he's sitting here preparing it. I was just checking out the death games. It's Generic and Anders right now, who are not online. However, it does look like Etho's got a kill in the game at some point. So he's kind of leading the pack right now with that one kill since we changed over to that kill counter. I just realized my health didn't regen all the way. That was kind of weird. I was on here over the weekend and spent a good solid 4 hours working on the hospital. I really had planned on coming back with some really good things for you guys. Oh, let me show you something real quick first if it's still there. I plan on coming back and having a lot of progress done on that thing, which unfortunately didn't go as well as planned because you would not believe how much cobble is needed to make a furnace-ridden floor, and wow, is it a lot. Where is... Oh, it must not be in this portal. I was, I had spent some time in the new terrain for a while, just exploring, looking for those donkeys, which I have yet to be able to find, but... Oh, is it gone? Wait, where is that new... There it is. Found out... I ran my horse all the way back, and there was a minecart sitting here that he happened to get stuck in. I didn't think that big of a deal on it, so I was just like, okay, let me get out and get rid of this minecart. You can't get the horse out of the minecart. He's stuck forever. I could probably go underneath and dig up, maybe? I think his hitbox is just bigger. Sorry, buddy. His hitbox is just bigger than the minecart, so I can't get him out. I don't really know what to do. I wonder if anybody else knows. Anyone know how to get a horse out of a minecart? So I left him here because I can't do anything with him. And apparently somebody else couldn't do anything with him either, so they just put a new minecart over there. they kind of moved on with life. It's not their horse. Can't. Horses' hitbox is bigger than the carts. Yeah, so I'm not really sure. Do I have any cactus? I didn't have any cactus with me. Push the cart into a cactus. Let me try that. Unfortunately for a cactus, I need to go back to my base because I don't have a cactus on me. Wow, that portal is super loud. That is not the right way. I was going the right way in the first place. Let me see if I can go rescue my horse. I don't think I left the cactus in my ender chest. I did not. I do have some sand in there, though, so that's good. I just need a piece of cactus, a sand, and we'll be good to go. Yeah, while we're over here, I'll show you guys real quick. I'm going to actually show kind of a start video and a build video of this stuff. And I took a lot of footage. I did a lot of a couple hours worth. Not all of it, but a lot of footage I did of me just doing this stuff. I'm going to put in like slow motion to music. But I came real close to getting the floor done. Got over to here on the floor. The ceiling is taking a long time, too. And I know a couple of you guys are still yelling that you really want these switches moved to the roof. I can't move them to the roof because the roof is also supposed to be aesthetically pleasing. So the best solution I have is doing it like it is now. And somebody said that it kind of reminds them of fire sprinklers. So I'm going to go with that. I kind of like that idea. I might have to rearrange some of them and get them. Whoa, Jesus, that scared the crap out of me. Holy crap. I seriously just jumped in my chair. That was ridiculous. Wow, that just scared the crap out of me. The lighting here, the reason it's all off is because I had originally done it so everything was spaced apart like this. Two in between and a light source. Not only does that not give enough light, but it doesn't make this thing even. So I was debating if I'm going to go with every row having a light, every other row having a light, which I started to do a little testing of over here, or what I'm going to do exactly. I think I'm going to go with every other row, but I didn't have time to finish it yet. It takes so much cobble to do all this way more than I ever anticipated. I multiple times went down and did some strip mining. I was strip mining looking for, I got some more diamonds. I think I'm up to 9 diamonds or something like that now. Not as much as I would want. Adlington graciously gave me a 240 ping. I don't see my ping, but I'm good. Adlington graciously gave me an entire chest full of cobble, and Pyro has also stated that he will give me as much cobble as I need so I can continue this on, which is great. I don't know if my sound is really loud in-game or if it's just I have really loud, my speakers turned up too high or not. Not really sure. So hopefully we'll be able to get that done at some point, but I couldn't work on it anymore. It was so many hours of doing it that I just needed to take a break from it and do something different. So, was it yellow? There he is. Okay, so I forgot to grab my sand, but it's right here, so that's okay. Just grab these. I'm gonna have to dig a little bit of this out. I don't want to. Let me move you. Gotta move you somewhere. Okay, there we go. So put sand there. Put a cactus. Oh, he's still on top of that block. There we go. Cactus there. I hope this doesn't kill the horse. Oh, good, 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 good. Now get. Whew. Yeah, Vex. Cactus worked. Nice. Poor horsey. Sorry about that, buddy. I was really not able to get him out of there. I guess I should have thought of something like a cactus. I just couldn't believe that his hitbox was bigger, and that really threw me off. I don't have any leads on me, which might be okay. He can just roam free for a while. Do I have any leads in this? I don't know what that guy just took damage from, but okay. I was going to say, I think it was environmental. I don't think I did anything to cause him damage. Whoa, sorry, horsey. I got to go back out and get healthed up again. Let's hope that he doesn't do too much crazy stuff and get himself killed. I could have been better off to leave him in there. He was definitely stationary. I do have some leads back at home somewhere, but that is not the purpose of what I'm doing. What I'm going to do today, I figure, is I'm going to work on the horse stable a little bit and actually give him a home. He's been homeless for too long. I do need to do some breeding, though. You guys are right, because he is a painfully slow horse. And I know you guys were complaining about his slowness. Imagine being the guy riding... Oh, wrong way. Imagine being the guy riding him. It is extremely painful to ride the horse when he's that slow. I keep going the wrong way. I don't know what is wrong with me today. Directionally challenge. But yeah, riding him is pretty brutal. So put him back over here. He stayed pretty well for me when I had him over in this corner. So let's just do that and hope for the best. I don't know. I don't even have any blocks to put him there. Stay there, horse. Good horse. That's what we're going with. It. He's a good horse, and he will stay there forever. So, need to go out, start getting some wood, work on this this horse stable a little bit in order to give him a proper home. So, I'm dealing with a slight issue from Newegg. It's not really Newegg's problem. I ordered a bunch of stuff. I got a new rig I got on the way. I was able to get in on a great deal on... a new i7 processor from Micro Center. I'm one of the lucky... There you are. I'm one of the lucky few who does live near a... Broke your helmet, bro. Make you burn because I broke your helmet, son. Oh, why are you messing with my crops? And, yeah, I'm one of the lucky few who live by a Micro Center, so I was actually able to get on a deal for a nice i7 chip for $199, which is extremely cheap compared to what they normally sell them for. So decided that since I could get it on that deal, I would get myself some supplies together to build myself a new rig. So figured, great, ordered a bunch of other supplies to go with it. Pretty much have everything I need except for an additional hard drive. I got an SSD that it's going to be running on, but I still need a hard drive for my, you know, standard programs that I'm installing and storage and things like that. So it's the only thing I was missing until yesterday. So turns out Newegg is now shipping a lot of their stuff through a company called like Lightsaber. Something like, actually, let me look real quick and see what that place is called. That is the wrong window to open up. This one. It is called Lasership. Lightsaber. Lightsaber. Lasership is what it's called. And I'd never heard of it before, so I was really confused by the tracking number, for one. But I was also confused because I was on my way home from work, and I got a phone call, and it was, I don't know how they got my number. They must have got it through Newegg, which is fine when you hear what that was for. They called me and said, we're here to deliver a package to, you know, blah, blah, blah at this address. And I said, okay, that's perfect. They said, are you home? And I said, no, not yet. I'll be home in like 10, maybe 15 minutes. I'm on the way as we speak, coming home from work. And they said, okay, well, we'll have to reschedule a delivery then. And I was like, okay. And they said, unless he wants to leave it at the front door. And I said, yeah, I'm going to be home momentarily. Go ahead and leave it at the front door. Why? It's daytime, you jerk. I said, yeah, go ahead and leave it at the front door. So I get home, maybe. And traffic ends up being, you know, relatively light from then on. So maybe it's another 10 minutes before I get myself home. So these people, they weren't even at my house yet. So I must have literally missed them based on the tracking time by like 4 minutes or something like that. So I pull up to my house, I look over, and I see in between my two doors, I can see a package sitting there. So I'm like, sweet. So I go up, I grab the package, go inside, not even thinking anything of it. Later in the evening, I'm like, okay, you know, I ordered a couple things that I'm waiting for to come in. This is, you know, one of my RAMs, what came in. I'm like, I wonder where the other stuff's at. So I kind of sit there for a minute and I'm like, let's look up the tracking number for this other stuff. So I looked it up and I noticed that they're both shipped by Lasership, which, like I said, I'd never really heard of before. But, and they both claim they were delivered 1 second apart. And I'm like, wait a minute here. So I run back outside, and this is a couple hours later, but I run back outside and I'm looking around and I'm like, I don't see anything else. So if I got that, then this can be, what was I doing over here exactly? I'm not exactly sure. I do need the top to be logs all the way around, but I'll do that later. I do need to give it some gates though. So let's build some gates here. So I'm looking around just to make sure I didn't miss the package outside anywhere. I don't see the package, you know, anywhere. So I call them and I say, you know, hey, I got a problem here. You guys claim to have delivered both of these packages and only one of them is here. And the lady, like, you know, gets all the information or whatever and says, okay, the driver's, you know, already gone for the day. We'll have to start an investigation and we'll get a hold of you by the close of business tomorrow. So they have all the details. So I have a feeling it's just a basic mistake, because here's my concept of this. My thought process of this is I got home 4 minutes after you deliver a package to my door. It is highly unlikely that somebody stole the package in that 4 minute time frame, let alone that they would only steal one of two packages that were delivered. Like, what are the odds that if you're going to steal package from somebody's doorstep, that you're going to take one of two that are sitting there and not just take them both? I mean, the odds of that are extremely slim. So my thought process is that, okay, this must be a mistake of some type. I don't know if I should, what I should keep in here. It's only one wide because it's not symmetrical like the rest of these ones are. This is 1, 2, 1, 1. I could probably even this out and make this more symmetrical, actually. Let's see about that. Yeah, so the odds are extremely thin that, you know, somebody stole the package and only took one of them and not both of them. But I'm concerned at this point that they're going to come back to me and kind of be like, well, you gave us permission to leave the package at your doorstep, therefore it's, you know, you're fully responsible for this. So I'm and this is speculation at this point, because I don't know what they're actually going to come back and say right now, because I'm still waiting for the, you know, the quote-unquote investigation to take place. I'm actually surprised I haven't heard back from them yet, since it's been... Well, that's weird. I didn't realize the gates opened... Oh. Opened a different way based on the way you were standing. That's kind of cool. That is pretty cool, actually. So I'm still waiting for them, and they said they were going to get back to me by close of business today, which is, I don't know what time frame their close of business is, considering I'm in a different, I could potentially be in a different time zone than where the headquarters of the company is at. So if I do this, I'm giving myself this, there we go. So that's all even now, and you're a spider. So this is all even now, come on, and I have like a little gate area over here where I can walk and store things if I wanted, so I could probably do the same over to this side. I don't know what I was thinking when I built this, and I could even make the middle like extremely big. Oh, you know what? I could do that. I could make the middle bigger, push this stuff back to the wall, and have like almost like a track in here. It's not going to be a big track, but one of those small like circle tracks that horses run. You know what they're called? Tracks. And that might look kind of cool. So let's take a look at that. How wide did I make this thing? It's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So if I do from here... 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So I got to go up to there. Okay. Yeah, so I'm just kind of waiting to see. It would kind of be really annoying if another package of mine got stolen. I did have one package stolen from me at the old address that I lived at. But, I mean, that was it was delivered at some point throughout the day. It just was not there when I got home. That easily could have just been taken. This one, it's the odds are just so, so slim that it was going to work out. And did that actually make it too long? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. That's 7 on the inside. Is that what I had here? Is it 6 on the inside? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Nope, just 6 on the inside. Okay, so got to drop this back one. Good. That actually gives me plenty more room to play with. That should be right. Good. So I'm hoping for the best, and I'm hoping, like I said, for honest mistake guy. I mean, they only told me on the phone that they were delivering one package, so I would think they would say some packages. They literally said we have a package. I mean, it was probably not the driver calling. It was probably somebody else who was calling, so they just might not know better. So I don't know. Really kind of wait this one out. I don't want to have to deal with it. I got a really good deal on that video card too, and I probably would be unable to replicate that deal right now with, you know, if I had to get a refund or whatever and started it over again. I'm betting that I can get, no matter how I look at it, I can probably end up getting a refund from whether it's from Newegg or, you know, this company or whatnot. I don't know. Well, got a door. Didn't mean to put that door there, but I got a door now. So, I don't know, but hoping that, you know, it was really an honest mistake, that'll be nice if that's truly the case. My mother, on the other hand, it was kind of funny that same, not, I can't say the same type of thing, because it's completely different, but this, what happened to her, like, what happened to me, you know, could be the fault of the people who delivered it, could be the fault of somebody who actually did steal a package, who knows, but, my mom recently, they're apparently switching over my whole neighborhood where I grew up at to natural gas, and a lot of it's in that area is based on propane. So good old Hank Hill and his propane, but it required them to go through and get new appliances. So they decided, well, they have to get all these new appliances and all, they're going to redo the kitchen in the process. So I guess a couple weeks ago, like 2 weeks ago now, they came over. They finally are almost done. They came over to put the final touches on the kitchen, part of which was to... What is going on here? One... Is that right? Yeah, that's right. Okay. To put the countertop in. So they got all the appliances in and they were putting the countertop in. So my mom was home when they were about to do this and she looked and she realized that there's this huge chip out of one part of the countertop. And she looked at it and she goes, no. You can't put this countertop in. There's a huge chip in it. Like, you need to go cut a new piece of counter. I'm not paying for a brand new countertop to have it be already mangled before it's even installed. So they took it back and went to deliver it. You went to install it yesterday, apparently. They did install it yesterday after going back and getting a new piece cut and all this stuff. And I talked to her today, and she was just like, can you believe this? She goes, I wasn't home this time. I get home and I look at it. She goes, it is the exact counter that I made them not install to take back and cut a new one. And I said, like the same counter or there's another chip in it? She goes, no, it's the exact same counter with the exact same chip in the exact same place. She's like, she was furious. So she called the company and was apparently, you know, expressing her, you know, disgust to them. And the manager got involved and he was like, what are you talking about? So he made some phone calls and now they're going to have to deal with it in a couple weeks. But in my mind, I'm hoping that, okay, let's hope that maybe this, what can I make this floor out of? Let's hope that maybe this countertop, again, benefit of the doubt, let them do their investigation and find out. Maybe they took it back, had a new countertop recut, loaded the wrong one up and came and installed it. For one, your builder's got a problem if they're not going to notice something like that, especially when they already came out once to install it and were denied because of a chip. Like, if you're putting a countertop in and has the same chip in it and you're still going to install it anyway, that's kind of ridiculous. What would this look like? That might be relatively interesting to have that as that top as the circle track that went around. Relatively cheap. Let's take a look at that. We're going to do things a little bit crazy. So we're going to make 17 of them for now. Just in case I don't like it, because it'll be just a big waste of wood. But let's say it wasn't an accident. How bad is that? You run a company where somebody refuses an install from you because something is damaged, and you come back out and try to replace the exact same damaged part. I mean, that's just horrible, horrible, horrible customer service. Like, oops, forget that I'm going to be giving out or digging through so much grass and getting grass blocks back because this is a silk touch item. Let's see. I'm not sure how to make a circle that well, so I'm just going to cut it all out for now until I get a circle down. Okay. And then we'll go back and fill in the blocks. That would make me mad. That would make me extremely mad. Like, I couldn't imagine, like, you know how much money it costs to, like, remodel things? It's not cheap. I guarantee it's not cheap for the company either. So when they screw up, yeah, it sucks that it costs them a lot of money. But you're going to pass that down to the homeowner because you screwed up? Like, oof, we got a problem if that's really the mentality behind that type of stuff. I mean, I don't even know what I would do in that case. I need to go over to 1212. Nope, not that one. How is this going to look? And then if I fill the rest of this back in. No, I definitely need some more. Oops, whether it's something like this and then this. The shovel's just too powerful. So I don't know, you guys got any crazy stories like that? Because that's something that I don't know. I would be so furious. I don't know what I would say to a company if they tried to do something like that to me. Well, this is going to make me want to do one here. I guess I can take some of these back out until I get this rounded corner part figured out. I do kind of like that the way this might look in the end, but I don't like that per se. Actually, if I do that, taking this away might be okay. No, that just doesn't look rounded enough now, does it? Oh, it's because that's off right there. I would need to do one. Ooh, that was weird. Big lag spike that I just hit. I think I would have to get rid of this one. It would be something like, oops. Something like that, and then I might be able to actually do two of those. Yeah, that's not bad. I think I can go for that. I'm not the greatest with circles and circles and shapes. Who needs those? So let's see if I can make it look just as good on the other end. I guess I'll just leave a hole there. Why not? Maybe a baby zombie will get stuck in it. So left, up, left, up. So basically be right, up, right, up. Boop. And then four. There. There. Did I really just use all those already? I did. I guess these things go a little bit faster than I was anticipating. Oops. Something like this. Yeah, that's kind of cool. That's kind of cool. I mean, it's nothing special. It's just like a stupid little, you know, the circle horse tracks that, you know, the horses come out and, you know, he can run around for a minute if he wants to. I don't know if that, don't they have like white lines or something in the middle of them? I don't know what I'll do in the center or something. Maybe put some sand or something in the center. Actually, it probably should have been sand all around and workbenches in the center for like the center mast area or something like that. But yeah, that doesn't look too bad. I should go get my horse, even though it's still kind of dangerous in here. I can go get my horse and get him in the door at least, and get him in one of those stables. I do need to knock this off. The carrot doesn't go through that well, so the horse can actually get in. But yeah, I don't know what you guys think of, you know, you guys have any fun stories of, you know, companies really trying to screw people over like that. I just realized that I'm not going to be able to do this that well. I can probably use Anders' portal better than mine to get my horse through, because for mine I would have to actually cut out. Hey, horsey. You're doing great, buddy. Doing great. Let me go see if I can, how easily I could use Anders' portal here. Is there plenty of room? Yeah, oh yeah, there's plenty of room there. As long as I don't start taking damage from moving my horse in here, which is, I guess, entirely possible. Ugh. So yeah, hopefully pretty soon I'll be able to get a lot more work done on the... Whoa, no. Oh, I'm done. Oh, I'm alive. I'm barely alive. Let's go heal. I don't think my horse is going anywhere. Let's not take any fall damage and let's go get healed up because that kind of hurt a lot. Now we'll get my horse in and we'll call this episode good, but we'll just... I don't have a roof on it yet, but I did make a little bit of progress in it. It looks decent on the inside. He'll be happy. Maybe he needs some artwork or something, you know. He's a very intellectual horse. He's not fast. He's intellectual. He's my smart horse. My other horses are going to be my dumb horses bred for speed. That's all they are. They don't need to be smart. They just need to be built for speed. That's what they're going to be. It is looking really good around this area, though. A lot of the things are... It makes my piddly little thing up there feel weak. I wonder if Arcus is in the death games. It would be really funny to just put on all the gear and go run charge out at Arcus and then just stop and be like, hey man, what's going on? See, I have this problem every so often. You come out here to heal and you only get a couple hearts and it stops the healing process. So, gotta kind of duck in and out a couple times in order to make this happen. Yeah, so hopefully my package will arrive. Hopefully I will get an email from them shortly saying, I'm sorry, Mr. Sano, we made a mistake. We didn't deliver it on accident. It was just in the truck to be delivered, and it got scanned as delivered, but we will bring it by. Hopefully it's not going to be like, nope, sorry, you're out of luck. You told us we could leave it there, therefore you're SOL, buddy. I actually didn't even know it was requiring a signature or anything like that, though, so I'm surprised it wasn't just left in the first place anyways. But, come on. Couple more hearts. Residual healing should get me to full. By the time, there we go. I was going to say by the time I get through here. So, in here. Take the horse through Anders' portal, where it's not by... I think it's close enough to... Yeah, it's got a stairway leading up to it, so it should be fine. Hey, buddy. And this is your beach. Right down to the beach. Wait, is this the one I want? Do I want the beach one? Village or home island. Wait, actually, like, let me take a look at this. Because maybe it might be the home island. Oh, the horse is making his way all the way up here. Oh, no, that's downstairs. Yeah, it's definitely got to be the beach one that I'm looking for. Should know I messed with it enough. I know it's not that other one. That other one is the up on his flying island, and I think I would kill my horse from the drop. Okay, so he's in. Let's hope that was the right one, because he's in. Yeah, this is the one I wanted. Oh, you're still going to fall down, aren't you? Slowly. There we go. Dun-dun-dun-dun. Dun-dun-dun-dun. And my home should be right over this way. You guys thought I was going the wrong way, didn't you? Zombie, skeleton. No bueno. Ow, 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 ow. Ow, ow, ow. Don't shoot my horse. Don't shoot my horse. He's a good horse. Bail. Bail. No. Good thing I went and healed up, man. These guys are crazy. Shut you. No, that's not shutting you. Oh, good God. I'm about to die. Go after him. Not me. Oh, no. I thought I dodged that thing completely. I better go shut this door quickly. Oh, it's already shut. Okay. Let me grab a simple little sword and get back out there. Oh, don't I end my episodes with a bang? I don't need a looting sword. Just give me this one. Give me some basic armor. and some blocks to close that baby back off. I should be okay. I cannot guarantee such things. I don't think he exists, so let's just do that. There we go. So that should be safe. I don't know where that skeleton went. That is not an open wall, right? Okay. Yeah, I need to put a lip on this because it's definitely dangerous with the spiders having the ability to get in, but which stall you want, buddy? No matter if you're my fast horse or my intellectual horse or what, you are still the first horse that has survived to do anything, so therefore you get your pick of the litter. You want that one? Okay, that one's yours. Boop. You chose it. Of course you did, you big jerk. I can't even get back in right now. I don't have a pick on me. I didn't plan on that being a problem. Here we go. Good horse. All right, guys. So it's not finished, obviously, because I need the roof. But it's coming along. It's looking better. I'll give him some hay bales and things like that. I think I made some actually in there. I'll give him some hay bales and things like that in there. So he'll be all happy and enjoy his life. And I just don't want that guy to look at me because he scares me a little. So, anyways, thanks for watching, guys. I will see you next time.